Hi everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how to use Desmos to find roots of polynomial functions. I'll also include how to use the rational root theorem, we'll do a little synthetic division, and then we'll factor the polynomial function when we're done. So we're going to use f of x is 7x to the 4th minus 12x cubed plus 19x squared minus 24x plus 10. We want to find all the roots and then we're going to write it in factored form. The very first thing I'm going to do is go over to Desmos and show you what this looks like. I put the function in. Make sure you're checking really carefully. It's easy to miss a sign or an exponent, so double check to make sure you have the right function. And then over on the right, you can see the function. Now, sometimes you might have to zoom in or zoom out, change the settings, but really we're only concerned with where does the function touch across the x-axis. We're looking for the x-intercepts. I'll zoom in a little bit so we can see it a little bit better. And then when I click anywhere on the graph, it's going to give me the x-intercept. So one of them I can see really easy. I have the number 1. The other one, though, says 0.714. That's not going to work for us. We need to have exact values. We don't want to have these decimal values. So we need to find out what this 0.714 number is. We need to figure out how to write it and how we could factor. I wrote down that x equals 1 is one of our factors. To find our other factors, we're going to use something called the rational root theorem. We take the last number in our polynomial, which is our constant, we're going to call that p. We're going to take the leading coefficient, 7, that's our q. We're going to list all possible ratios we can form with factors of p and factors of q. Let's write that down. So p, the number 10, has factors of plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 5, plus or minus 10. Q has factors plus or minus 1, plus or minus 7. When I put P over Q together, I have plus or minus 1 divided by 1, which is 1, 2 divided by 1, which is 2, 5 divided by 1 is 5, 10 divided by 1 is 10. Then I'm going to divide by 7, so plus or minus 1 over 7, plus or minus 2 over 7, plus or minus 5 over 7, and plus or minus 10 over 7. So what the rational root theorem says is if there's a rational that is a root of this function, it will be one of these numbers. The good news is that Desmos is giving us a hint. We can see the 0.714. It tells me this number is positive and it is less than 1. So when I go back to this long list of numbers, I can get rid of a bunch of them. I don't need the 2, the 5, the 10. I also don't need 10 over 7 because 10 over 7 is greater than 1, and I already know that 1 is a solution, so I'm not going to look at it either. I only need to look at 1 over 7, 2 over 7, and 5 over 7. Back in Desmos, I'm going to type f of 1 over 7, which is not equal to 0. I'm going to try f of 2 over 7, also not 0. Then we'll try f of 5 over 7. Which gives us 0. So this is the other intercept that we could see on the graph. In fact, if you type 5 over 7, you'll see that it's about 0.714. So let's write that in. We have x is 1, we have x is 5 over 7. A polynomial of degree 4 is going to have 4 roots altogether. They might be unique, they might be repeated, but we have to find a way to find the other 2 roots. I'm going to use something called synthetic division to help us find the other roots. Synthetic division is just a different way to do normal division. What I do is I start with my factor I know, which is 1, and I put it in a box. Then I write the coefficients of all the terms of my polynomial. I write 7, negative 12, positive 19, negative 24, and positive 10. The first term always comes straight down, so I have 7. Then I multiply by the number in the box. 1 times 7 is 7, and then I add, I get negative 5. 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. 19 minus 5 is 14. 1 times 14 is 14. I add negative 24 and 14. I get negative 10. Then 1 times negative 10 is negative 10. This gives me 0. Our process replicated dividing by x minus 1. We're going to do the same thing with 5 over 7. I'm going to put 5 over 7 in a box. I'm going to draw a line. I'm going to bring the 7 down. 5 over 7 times 7 is just 5. Negative 5 and 5 is 0. 5 over 7 times 0 is 0. 14 and 0 is 14. 5 over 7 times 14 is a positive 10. negative 10 and 10 gives me 0. This replicates dividing by x minus 5 over 7. What happened is now that I've divided by x twice, I've gone from power 4 down to power 2. Each time I divide by x, I reduce the exponent. This 7 then represents 7x squared plus 0x plus 14, which I can write is 7x squared plus 14. 7x squared plus 14, I can set equal to 0 to find my remaining roots. This says 7x squared equals negative 14, which means x squared is equal to negative 2. When I take the square root of each side, I get that x is equal to plus or minus the square root of 2i. Now I have all four roots. From Desmos, we found the numbers 1, 5 over 7. Then we found our other two roots are plus the square root of 2i and minus the square root of 2i. Now that we have the roots, we can go back and write the polynomial in factored form. To write our polynomial in factored form, we take each of the factors, x equals 1, x equals 5 over 7, x equals negative the square root of 2i, and x equals positive the square root of 2i, and we bring the number to the left side. So I'll have x minus 1 is 0, x minus 5 over 7 is 0, x plus the square root of 2i is 0, and x minus the square root of 2i is 0. We'll drop the zeros and make these factors of our polynomial. We have x minus 1, x minus 5 over 7, x plus the square root of 2i, and x minus the square root of 2i. The last thing we need to do is a quick check to make sure our leading term would be equal to what we had in our original function. Originally, we were given that f of x was 7x to the fourth. If we think about multiplying out this polynomial, we would only have x to the fourth. I need to put a 7 in front to match our leading coefficient. You have two choices for how to write the final answer. You could leave it like this with the 7 in front. You could also multiply the 7 through the factor x minus 5 over 7, which would give us f of x is x minus 1 times 7x minus 5, x plus the square root of 2i, and x minus the square root of 2i.